Hello and welcome to the Knowledge Mint. Today we are going to discuss PLSQL. Right? Let's see. What is cursor? Oracle Engine uses a work area for its internal processing in order to execute SQL statements. Means, without cursor, no SQL statement can be executed. Means, by default, we have been using cursor. This is a work area which is private to SQL operation and is called cursor. So, cursor is nothing but a buffer area which Oracle Engine uses for its internal processing in order to execute SQL statements. When you try to run any SQL statement at the time, the data is collected from the database and is stored inside the cursor. And that data is called active data set. Whatever data you are going to store inside cursor is called active data set. Yeah? So, what is a cursor? It's a work area for executing SQL statement. And this work area is private to SQL operation and it is called cursor. Whatever data we are going to store or is fetched inside the cursor is called active data set. So it's nothing but a buffer area. You can say work area, buffer area, which is used by Oracle Engine to process SQL statements, right? Now, types of cursor. There are two types of cursor. One is implicit, second one is explicit cursor, right? And mind well, after the end of this particular session, I will separately give you a practical session on cursors where all the PLSQL programs related to implicit cursor as well as explicit cursor will be executed. So this whole video related to cursor will be divided into three parts. Part 1, which I am just now recording, will have all theoretical concepts related to cursor, whether it is implicit cursor or explicit cursor. In second video, I will be demonstrating use of implicit cursor and its attributes. In third video, I will be explaining use of explicit cursor and its demonstration with the help of its attributes, right? So, right now we are going to focus on implicit cursor. What is implicit cursor? If Oracle Engine opens a cursor, that is buffer for its internal processing, then it is known as implicit cursor, right? So by default, every Oracle Engine uses implicit cursor. And this cursor is a predefined cursor. It is associated with DML statement. You all know that. What is a DML statement? Like insert, update, delete. Clear? Next. It is also called SQL cursor. Why it is called SQL cursor? Because its name is SQL. The name of an implicit cursor is SQL. Wherever you will be using implicit cursor, the default name is SQL. Suppose in this case, why to use a cursor? This is the very good example of that, the need of the cursor. Suppose we have written a PLSQL block. This is begin, delete from EMP. We all know that EMP table, where EMP number is equal to 7778. After the end of this particular, after the execution, we'll get a message that procedure successfully executed. There may be question in our mind that whether this is not where, this is whether row have been deleted or not. Or there may be question that how many rows deleted, right? So for question like this can be answered with the help of implicit cursor, implementation of implicit cursor. Now we'll go ahead with the attributes of the cursor. Attributes of implicit cursor is open, whether the cursor is open or not. If cursor is open, this attribute is going to return true, otherwise it will return false. So by default, that opening and closing of implicit cursor is managed by Oracle engine. We need not to work on this particular attribute of implicit cursor. Now we have our next attribute, that is called found. It returns true if record fetched successfully. Suppose you are writing a query, select star from EMP. Clear? And after execution of this command, that all records of EMP table will be inside SQL cursor. In that situation, this percent found attribute will return true. But if you are going to write a select star from EMP where department number equals to 50, there is no department as 50. In that case, no record will be fetched. So the output of percent found will be false. Similarly, it is the reverse of found. If records are fetched inside the cursor, in that case, this will return true. Otherwise, it will return false. And this is the very useful, attributes. It returns number of row fetched from the cursor. Like in the previous slide, here we have deleted records of 7788. Ideally, one record have been deleted, but there is no confirmation. For such kind of problem, we can use row count. It will return that how many records are deleted. Next, to discuss the use of SQL percent found, where SQL is the name of implicit cursor. And percent found is the attribute of implicit cursor which we are going to use. So, say this PL SQL block. Again, we are going to update EMP table. What we are going to do? In this particular program, we are going to update salary of an employee by 15% on entering the employee number. This statement will ask for the employee number of the employee, and this update statement will update that employee's salary by 15%. Now we need to know the confirmation whether that given employee number exists or not. If it is exist, so whether the salary is updated or modified or not. See, if suppose I am going to enter 7788, right? 8 and 8, right? I know that 7788 employee number exists in the EMP table. In that case, SQL percent found will return true. SQL, we all know that name of the implicit cursor. Percent found, if that implicit cursor gets some records based on this condition, in that case this will return true. And if this condition is true, in that case this statement will be executed. Means we all know that DBMS underscore output dot put underscore line is a package which is used for displaying messages to the user. This will display employee record modified successfully. Otherwise, if this 7788
does not exist in the EMP table, in that case this condition will be false. In that case, else part of the code, or you can say that else part of if, will be executed. This will say employee number does not exist. Clear? So ideally, with the help of this implicit cursor, we are able to provide confirmation to the user whether the command executed has done something or not. It's a kind of confirmation. Clear? If something had happens in form of, or you can say that user update, or in form of a message. It says simple, when you will run this particular code, it will ask for an employee name. If an employee name exists in the table, it will modify its salary by adding 15% of the salary to the salary, and then it will give you a message, employee record modified successfully. Otherwise, it will give you a message that employee number does not exist. That gives a confirmation to the user, that user can understand what happened or what not. Now, so this is the example of SQL percent not found. SQL, we all know that SQL is the name of implicit cursor, and not found is the attribute. It is the reverse of found. What we are going to do in this particular code, in this code, if that record is not found, means if this condition is not true, will return message employee number does not exist. And if the given employee number is correct and is available in the EMP table, in that case it will show message employee record modified successful. If means if this condition is true, then it will show message employee record does not exist. And when this condition will be true, when the given employee number will not be there in the table, means when record is not fetched, this not found will return true. When record is fetched, otherwise in that case it will return false. In case of true, means no modification done. In case of false, modification done. So this is the reverse of found attribute. Now we are going to learn the next attribute, that is SQL percent row count. Clear? We all know that SQL is the name of the cursor. Percent row count is the attribute which gives you number of record returned or fetched into the cursor. For that we need to take a variable called number of row affected. This will be there in book of Ivan Barrows also. Same example given over there. So row affected is the name of the variable. Its data type is char, size 4. We have begin with PL SQL block, update command. It will update salary by 15%, where job equals to salesman, right? So this is a fixed, there is no input required. We have given input in the code. For salesman, if that this job exists in the EMP table, the salary of every salesman will be increased by 15% of salary, right? And this row affected will get, because this will return a numeric number, SQL percent row count. You suppose there are 5 salesmen are there in the EMP table, this SQL percent row count will return 5, and this 5 will be converted into character and then will go into row affected variable. Now we are going to use if condition with SQL percent row count. Means if SQL percent row count, which is a numeric value, supposing 5 salesmen are there, in that case this SQL percent row count is greater than 0, means this condition is true. What we are going to give as a message, row affected means 5, employee's record modified successfully. We'll print row affected and then we'll support it. Employee record modified successfully means if there are 4 salesmen, we'll say 4 record modified successfully. If there are 5 salesmen, then it will say 5 record modified successfully. Otherwise, suppose nobody is working as salesman. In that case, row count will return 0, which is not greater than 0. In that case, this condition will be false and this else part will be executed. And this message will be shared with the user, there are no employee working as salesman. That's how, if in any case, if you want to know that how many records have been modified, how many changes have been done, suppose if I am writing delete from EMP where department number equals to 30, and suppose in department number 30, that is 30, having 5 records or 5 employee working means 5 records have been deleted. If we want to know that how many records have been deleted, if you want to know with the help of a PLSQL block, in that case we need to use row count attribute of implicit cursor and will be able to tell to the user that 5 records have been deleted, or we can say no record have been deleted, or we can say no record found. Clear? So this was all about implicit cursor. Now we'll learn explicit cursor. As name suggests, if a user opens a cursor for processing of data, then it is called explicit cursor. You can say a user defined cursor is called explicit cursor. Here it is associated with select statement and returns more than one row. Where? So it has some attributes like is open, percent found, not found, and row count. Let us discuss it one by one. Is open. It returns true if cursor is open, otherwise false. You all know that in case of explicit cursor or user defined cursor, cursor has to be open. If cursor is open, only then you will be able to use it. Found will return true if records fetch successfully in the cursor, otherwise it will return false. Means whatever DML statement or you are going to give, if it is going to fetch some records, if that condition is true, in that case, means percent found, you can understand, if records are found, it will return true. If records are not found on that condition, it will return false. Not found is simply you can connect when records are found or a particular DML statement, it will return true. Sorry, if records are not found, in that case it will return true, otherwise it will return false, right? And row count will tell you that how many records fetched in the cursor for a given DML statements, right? If you are going to update, in that case, matlab kitne record update hue. If you are going to delete, it will say that how many records have been deleted. Clear? Now we need to learn explicit cursor management. When it comes to implicit cursor, everything is managed by the Oracle engine. Opening of the cursor, declaration of the cursor, declaration of the cursor, opening of the cursor, fetching of data, processing of data, exiting, and then closing the cursor. This all is done by the Oracle engine. Users need not to worry. But when it comes to declaration of or use of explicit cursor, in that case, you need to follow the 6 steps of explicit cursor management. First of all, declare a cursor mapped to a SQL statement that retrieves data for processing. Suppose, if I need to process a data like employee number, name, salary, job, commission for department number 20. In that case, the definition of the cursor will be add select EMP number, name, job, commission from EMP where department number, you can take any department. Is whatever data you want to process, you need to write query for that. That is called declaration of cursor with the help of query. You all know that cursor is a buffer area, you can say work area. तो जिस भी डेटा पे आपको काम करना है वो डेटा कर्सर में लाना पड़ेगा, और डेटा को कर्सर में लाने के लिए यू नीड टू राइट अ सीक्वल स्टेटमेंट. क्लियर? नाउ यू नीड टू ओपन दैट कर्सर आफ्टर डिक्लेरेशन, देन यू नीड टू फेच डेटा फ्रॉम कर्सर एंड इट इज डन वन रो एट अ टाइम इन मेमोरी वेरिएबल. श्योर यू नीड टू transfer data from cursor to memory variable, then you can work upon, then you can process as per your requirement the data which is there inside memory variable, and you can use loops also. If there is one record, no problem. When there are multiple record, this loop will go on, and finally once all data is processed or all data, all records are processed, this loop will complete and you will come out of the loop. Once you are out of the loop, you need to close the cursor. Means when the usage of cursor is no more, you need to close, because that saves memory, right? Now see, these are the three commands which are used when you try to use explicit cursor. Fetch command, fetch data from active data set to memory. Active data set means from, you can say, from cursor to memory variables. Open is used for opening the cursor, and close command is used for closing the cursor and releasing the memory. Now this is the syntax for cursor declaration. You need to use keyword cursor, then you need to write name of the cursor, and then you need to write a valid select statement. Like here, what I have done, I have created a cursor, or you can say I have declared a cursor. Cursor, this is the name of the cursor. Cursor _emp is the name of the cursor. Is, then you need to write a valid select statement. Any select statement, right? Select emp number, e name, salary from emp where department number equals to 20, means inside cursor _emp cursor you will have employee name, employee number, employee name, salary for department number 20. These three fields will be there, and where all records belongs to department number 20. This will be there inside this cursor. And then you can process. Let's see one example of explicit cursor. Declare, we all know that we need to declare, because cursor is also a variable. Clear? Cursor, this is the name of the cursor, C1. You can take any name. Age, select star from EMP, means we have taken complete data of EMP table to this cursor T1. Okay. Then this is another variable of row type. You can recall it. Row type means it is able to hold complete row of EMP table. So how its type and size is defined? This record is row type of size EMP table, means this E_rec variable will be able to hold complete one record of EMP table with all columns. Clear? whenever you need to handle the complete record of a table, you need to go for row type of variable. Clear? Then cursor declared, variable created for holding the record. Then we are going to open it. We have opened the cursor. Now we are going to fetch. What? Fetch C1 into eRec. Mind well, at a time केवल एक ही record का data fetch होता है, one by one. First record which is there inside in C1 will go to eRec, and eRec is able to store complete record fetched from C1 to inside it. Clear? Means first record will be completely inside e underscore rec variable, which is of type record. Sometimes we also call it composite variable. Composite variable which is able to hold more than one data inside it. Now, after this, we all know that DBMS output dot put underscore line. This is the heading number. You can say employee number. And then we are going to print EMP number of eRec. Loves complete record may say EMP number hum yahan pe print karna cha raha. That's why we have used eRec dot EMP number. So we have specified the specific value from eRec variable. Then name. We have taken name from eRec. Salary. We have taken cell. If you want to add some more details like job, commission, department number, what you need to do? You need to write DBMS output dot put underscore line. Write down here in place of, in addition to salary, write down job, and write down here eRec dot job, then eRec dot commission, then eRec dot MGR number, then eRec dot hire date. You can add any number of, because everything is there inside C1, because you have put no condition. You have taken all records. Star means all records, all row, all column from EMP table. And see, this is the beginning of the loop. This is the end of the loop. Here, this is the ending condition. It says exit when C1 percent not found. Means this loop will run till all records have been processed. Jaise hi records sare khatam ho jayenge, the processing of all records is over, immediately this loop will terminate. After that, as a good programmer, you need to close it, because this will release memory occupied by C1 and which is equal to EMP table. You can understand it is huge in size. So we have learned what is a cursor, its type, its attributes, and we have used its attributes, whether it is open, percent is open, percent found, percent not found, percent row count, and we have also learned explicit cursor management, right? Like declaration of cursor, then opening of cursor, then fetching of records from the cursor, after that processing of records of the cursor, then closing the cursor. So this was the theoretical part related to cursor, and in next video I will run all the programs displayed here, discussed here in cursor part 2. And in cursor part 3, I will discuss the program related to explicit cursor. I would like to request you all kindly like and subscribe my channel. Thank you so much. I'd like to request, please like and subscribe my channel, Knowledgement. That will motivate me a lot. Thank you so much.